Hi, this is CADCAM Lessons channel, and this is the second part of the tutorial in which I cover the basics of creating 3D models in FreeCAD. FreeCAD is a fully free 3D CAD system, and I think that in many cases this system can work well and can be an interesting alternative to other such programs. Before we go any further, please subscribe to this channel, and if you haven't seen the first part of this tutorial, the link to the first part will be in the description of this video. And now we will go over the basics. And here, as you can see, I have this project saved, and to save the project in FreeCAD, we do it in the standard way as in other systems. Simply choose File and Save As, and specify the location of the file where this project will be saved. And if we make any changes, then we can simply overwrite that file by selecting Save or simply clicking that icon. And in FreeCAD you can have several projects open at the same time, and these projects will appear here and in the operation tree, and you can switch between these projects. But for now we will focus on one project. We will be working on a single file, and as I mentioned earlier, one single solid is a body, and here as we create more parts of this 3D solid, we are going to add more operations, we are going to add more sketches. It's going to show up here in the operations tree, and it's just going to be assigned to this body. If we would like to create another part in this project, we can simply create another body here, and then we will already be working on another part. But at this point we will focus on this part. Here, if you want, you can rename this body. All you have to do is right click and choose rename, or just press F2 key on your keyboard, and you can specify the name of this body. And you can enter here such a name that suits you, and in a similar way you can rename the operations, and here we can also change the name. And specifying your own names, operations or solids, can be useful for more complex projects. Then, if we specify a name that accurately describes the selected operation, such a thing can simply make it easier to locate the selected operation. And okay, at the end of the first part of tutorial, I mentioned that we can create sketches not only on the basic planes of the coordinate system, but also on the faces of the model. And here I mean such flat faces. They can be angled face, but just so that here is a flat surface, because this is also a solid face. However, here when we select this face and I choose to create sketch, this face cannot be a sketch plane. It must be a flat surface. And in this case, we will create another sketch on this face, and to create sketch on the face, simply select this face and choose Create Sketch command. And at this point, the selected face is the sketch plane, and now on this face, we create a sketch. Here, as far as the sketcher module is concerned, there is another important thing. Here we have such an icon, and if we expand this menu, I have selected these two options, and at this point I will not explain what these options are responsible for. Just make sure you have these options enabled, and we will now move on to creating the sketch. We will create another geometry here. For example, let's create a rectangle like this, and here the command is still active. Right click to cancel this command. And as with the sketch of this part, this sketch is also not dimensioned and not constrained, but I'll leave it that way. And now let's close the sketch, and based on this sketch I'm going to add an extrusion, and here we specify the length of the extrusion, and click OK to accept it. And this is how we create another piece of this solid. We added another extrusion, and here, as you can see, another operation has appeared, operation path 001, and this is simply another extrusion, and in this operation is the sketch from which this operation was created. Now we will move on to editing this sketch. And now we are going to add dimensions and define the position of this sketch. Let's add a horizontal dimension, select this line and enter here 50 millimeters. Okay, and now when it comes to dimensions, as in this case, I first select the dimension I want to use, then I select the geometry. And in the previous part of this tutorial, I showed you that you can select the geometry first and then select the dimension you want to add, but we can also add distance between points. And now right click to cancel this command, and if I select this point and this point and select vertical dimension, I can also specify this dimension here. And here I enter 30 millimeters, and this rectangle is dimensioned. But even though this rectangle is dimensioned, its position is not specified. And in this case, we can specify the position of this rectangle relative to the origin of the coordinate system. I will add more dimensions here. First, I will specify the horizontal distance between these two points. And here enter 40 millimeters. Now select these two points again. And I remind you that in the sketcher module, if we select some elements, we don't have to hold down the control key. We just select elements with the left mouse button. And let's add another dimension and here enter 35 millimeters. And now the sketch is fully constrained. Let's close the sketch. And the changes have been automatically applied to the solid. I'll go back to edit this sketch again. And specifying the location, this geometry relative to the origin of the coordinate system is not exactly convenient. In this case, the better solution would be that the next part that will be created based on this sketch should be related in some way to the solid that is already created. Now I'm going to close this sketch and go to edit the sketch on the basis of which this part was created. And I'm going to change these dimensions a little bit. I'm going to move this sketch relative to the origin of the coordinate system. For example, 30 millimeters here and also 30 millimeters here. Okay, close the sketch and notice how it looks. Now I'm going to again to edit this sketch. And here I'll enter, for example, 50 millimeters and here 45. Okay, close the sketch. And now it looks like this. This part of the solid is not related with this part, but this part is related with the origin of the coordinate system. And if you are creating another part of 3D solid, it is usually better for this part to be related to the previous part. That is, in this case, it would be better for this solid fragment to be related with this solid fragment. I will move on to editing this sketch. I will remove these dimensions. And now let's add dimensions relative to this solid. However, if I select dimensioning and I would like to specify the distance from this point to this edge, you can see this point I can select, but I cannot select this edge or any other geometry on this solid. I can't use any point of this geometry. And for this purpose, in order to be able to use some geometry of this solid, first we must create a reference geometry. And to do this, select create external geometry command and select the geometry that we want to be the reference geometry. In this case, select this line and right click to cancel this command and select the horizontal dimension, select this point, and now as you can see I can select this point and I can specify the dimension here, and here enter 15 millimeters and select this dimension, select these two points, and here enter 20 millimeters, and as you can see this sketch is fully constrained. Again, close the sketch and now it looks like this. And now if I go to edit this sketch, here let's change these dimensions to 20 millimeters. Okay, close the sketch. And all the time this part is in the same place. Similarly, if I edit this sketch and change the length of this rectangle, here for example 200 millimeters and here for example 120 millimeters, close the sketch, and the position of this part of the 3D solid is strictly related to this vertex, and relative to this vertex, relative to these edges, we have certain dimensions, and these dimensions are constant, no matter what the dimensions of this solid will be. And here, simply when it comes to such dimensioning and determining the position of successive pieces of geometry, it all depends on what we want to achieve. Here in this case, we wanted to specify a fixed distance of this piece of solid from these edges. And this is what we can achieve with dimensions. And okay, here, based on the sketch we created on this wall, we add another fragment of this solid. And of course, we can add more such fragments. We can create another sketch, for example, on this face. I select this face, select create sketch, and here I will create any geometry on this face. Okay, close the sketch, and we can add another piece of 3D solid based on this sketch. Let's add another extrusion for 10 millimeters. And okay. And as in the previous sketch, we can link this sketch to this piece of solid, or we can link this geometry to this piece of solid, or we can link this geometry to the origin of the coordinate system. And first, I will define the diameter of the circle. Let's enter here, for example, 15 millimeters. Okay. And now I would like to specify the position of this circle relative to this piece of geometry. So I choose the create external geometry command. I select this line to create the reference geometry. And now relative to this point, I can add dimensions. And okay, the sketch is fully constrained. Close the sketch, and this is how we can add more parts of the 3D solid. And when it comes to specifying the position of a geometry relative to another geometry, as here in this case we used dimensions and specified a fixed position of the geometry relative to another geometry, For this purpose, we can also use constraints. And constraints are something that determines the relationship of one geometry to another geometry. And when it comes to constraints, we will start this topic in the next part of this tutorial. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching. And if you don't want to miss the next part of this tutorial, please subscribe to this channel.